Hello amazing people out there, it's Brutus Richard, officially welcoming you to Old Town.
My name is Tunji Akinseyemwa and I'm the DOP on Old Town.
My name is Ifu Enada. I play the role of Amara in Old Town.
My name is Paul Utomi, and in this movie, I play the character called Peace.
My name is Dervin, and I'm playing the character Pami in film Old Town.
My name is Lucy Ame. I play the role of Jenny in the film Old Town.
My name is Carlo Ikaguo. I play the character of Chairman.
My name is Uzoma Mike Ebuka. I'm the production designer of Old Town.
My name is Oge Obasi and I'm the producer for the film Old Town. Old Town is a gangster thriller. It's set in the city of Owerri in Imo State. It's the story of Peace, who is a gangster wannabe and who was trying to rise to the top of the triangle of the underworld.
Old Town has been in, should I say, in its hatching stage in incubation stage for about 4 years now. I conceived the idea sometime in 2011 because I grew up in Owerri and there were stories that I felt were peculiar to the small town lifestyle of Owerri, especially as regards to, you know, gangsters who lived in this city and, you know, small town hustlers and so on and so forth. So those stories, you know, growing up and hearing them, they kind of resonated many ideas in my head, you know, especially because I always wanted to make, you know, gangster films. I've always been, you know, influenced by, you know, the great gangster films from The Godfather to Casino to Goodfellas, you can name them, but, you know, I've always wanted to tell, you know, gangster stories the way I experienced, you know, gangster stories. And the way I experienced gangster stories is, you know, definitely, you know, growing up in, you know, where, a small town. So that was basically the, should I say, like the birthing seed for writing the script, Old Town.
Jenny is this beautiful young girl. Jenny is one very feisty character. Jenny is that person who quarrels and can fight on the street. She's this girl who is very jealous. She's emotional too, she's possessive. She doesn't want anybody coming close to her boyfriend. And she's friends too with Amara.
This is my first time working with CJ in a film. The script, when I read it, I fell in love with the story, man. I was born and raised in Owerri, schooled in Owerri. So coming down here to do this film is like, it's an honor to me, man, honestly. It's an honor that I'm shooting a film about Owerri, my hometown. It's the best experience I've ever had in the film business.
When I first got the call from my director, CJ Obasi, about his next project, Old Town, I was very thrilled. I was very thrilled because after working with him on his first project, Ojuju, and having an up-close personal relationship with him and seeing what he could come up with, I really, really did look forward to this project. When eventually I did get the script, I was blown away. I was blown away by the different characters that made up the whole.
Amara is a very sweet, naive girl in her early 20s who's been able to look beyond skin deep to see the beauty in the lord of all thugs, Peace. She's so in love with Peace. She's his girlfriend. Regardless of all the bad boy-ness, if I can use that word, you know, that he's all about, she's in love with Peace and she's always there, and she's pretty much a peace loving person. No wahala, easy going. She's Jenny's friend and she's also cool with the guys. I mean, I'm talking about Peace's goons, that's Sheriff and Pami. She's the kind of girl that everybody loves, you know, because she's always fun loving basically. That's just who Amara is.
Peace is an ambitious street thug who I think has delusions of grandeur. He comes from a very poor and impoverished background. He is smart, but clearly lacks any finesse or civility. He wants to use every and any means that he can to amass wealth and influence in the city of Owerri.
Sheriff is a great character, I must confess. He's smart, he's fun to be with in as much as he's straight, and you can never ever ever predict him. You never see him coming. Cool guy, but when he reacts, you're like, damn, this guy is mean.
Okay, Pami is he's a nutcase, you understand what I'm saying? He's a nutcase. He's like he grew up in a rough neighborhood, you know, alongside Peace and Sheriff, you know. They are the roughnecks in the States, you know. They're just, you know, they want to take over. The drug gang, the pimping, the everything, anything that has to do with the underworld activity, you know, they love to take over. Lagos is a bit, I can say that Lagos has the same, you know, kind of people and kind of feeling. But Owerri, as a whole, people are real down here. They don't pretend at all. You see what I'm saying? We don't pretend in any way. You know? We love to express ourselves at any point in time, anywhere, anytime, any day. You understand?
Peace, Pami, and Sheriff are close friends. Peace is the brain of the entire operation. Sheriff is his right-hand man, and Pami is obviously the muscle. They have been able to carve some sort of niche for themselves in the undergrounds of the city of Owerri, extorting people, dabbling in drugs, prostitution, crime, peace more so. He wants to get to the very top. He isn't satisfied with the little he's got, and he would do anything to get there. And he knows one thing, his friends will follow him anywhere he goes. So I could say, or you could say, they're a very loyal bunch.
My director, CJ Obasi, and I have been talking for a while. I know we've been talking about my character all the time, you know, and all that, what I can do to make it better. And then he had me go watch some films like Carlito's Ways, Casino, Goodfellas. And then I was opportune to watch one or two of them. And then my director said I should take note of the female lead characters in such films so that I will know what I'm expected to do. And I think it helped.
When I read the scripts, I was very interested in it. I always enjoy an opportunity where I get to speak a little ego, what little ego I can speak. And we agree that the character Chairman is a sort of underground boss who has his fingers in many pies, illegal trade, prostitution, drugs and everything. And we talked about the best way to portray it. It's kind of gritty. He said he wanted a gritty feel to it. And by the time we finished, I gathered he was a very, very intelligent person, and like me, thinks in pictures. And so we agreed to play it in a kind of kind of roughened person who's struggling to refine himself and lift himself above the cesspool that he's in. Albeit, you know, that uncouth part of it comes out anytime he's aggravated and stuff. So that's what we decided to play it. This sort of quasi-civilized, sophisticated person that just falls apart every time, you know, he gets irate or something. And that's how we chose to play it, simply put.
Personally, I'm a child who grew up in my own way. I grew up in the streets, so to say. I'm always in the streets. And when I read the script, I had to, like, when I thought about it, I was like, okay, I think this is what I'm called to do. It's now time for me to, like, bring out my own homework and then put my A's together to make sure the film gets what it wants.
Well, I'm very, very proud of the cast that I have. I have an amazing cast. People kind of know me as, you know, the guy who doesn't, like, work with, you know, the so-called big names, you know, but, you know, I'm working with a lot of fresh actors, you know, people who have been in the game, but you might not like see them like every day. I have Paul Otomi who plays the lead. He plays a character called Peace. It's a very interesting character. You should look out for, you know, his performance in this film. We have Brutus Richard who plays Sheriff. We have Delvin Ifani who plays Pami. You know, very fun character as well. Very, you know, ghetto and grimy, you know, character. We have Kali Kago, who is, you know, probably like the only big name we have on the film. But, you know, he plays something quite different from what you're normally used to see him play. And then we have guys like Olu Alvin, who plays a character called Viper, very mysterious, enigmatic, you know, hustler. And then on the female side, we have Ifwe Nada, who plays Amara, and Lucy Ame, who plays Jenny. You know, it's a very interesting mix, you know, of characters and, you know, and actors that we have lined up. And, you know, it'll be something very, very, very fun to watch. I guarantee you that. You can't make a film without an amazing team. You can't. You really can't. And even more so when you're on a budget. You need people who, I can't stress this enough, people who love film. People who are passionate about film. That's the only way you can pull it off. And that's exactly what I have. I've just been lucky, you know, to be able to always, somehow, I always find myself collaborating with people who have a pure love for film. And because of that, it kind of makes things easier. Not that it makes it easier, but it kind of reduces the stress of having to, the stress you deal with having to struggle with people who are doing it for, say, material reasons or, you know, financial reasons or, you know, whatever ulterior motives they may have. But, you know, it kind of makes things easy and it makes people know why they, you know, to be professional. You know, people are professional, they come on set, they know what's expected of them and they do it to the T. You know, so that's, you know, that's something you can't even buy with money. You know, it just has to be there. They just have to be the kind of people who are that way. And I'm just lucky, you know, to have such people working on this project over time. We can only tell our stories because, you know, one of the misconceptions we have is trying to do Hollywood films, you know, the way they do Hollywood films, which is really, you know, absurd because, number one, we don't have the kind of budget they have. You know, we don't even have 1/10 or 1/20 of, you know, the kind of budget they have or the manpower or the technical know-how. You know, we don't have any of these things. But what we do have going for us is that we have unique stories. And so those are the kind of things that, you know, we can export. Our own unique storytelling ability is universal. You know, a good story is a good story, wherever you take it to.
I had to look deep and try to visualize what Sherry's character would be like. I had to draw inspiration from my environment, from the different experiences of the street thugs who go around trying to make a living for themselves. And I had to try as much as possible to bring this character to life. In as much as it had few lines, it was more action and a more direct approach. It was more like Peace alter ego, always putting him in check and putting out to him his views and his takes on if the move was right or if it was wrong.
You can see a whole lot of Pami in a way, a whole lot of them. But I'm not trying to say that everybody here is crazy. You know what I'm saying? But a lot of rough, you know, aggressive looking people down here. But at the same time, they're still very friendly. And a very, very, you know, accommodating at the same time, you know. When you watch Pami in Old Town film, you see Owere, you see the slang, you see the swag, you see the attitude, you see everything.
I always enjoy working with directors who are editors. I don't know, and he's a writer as well. I had a discussion with him and I was amazed at his insight. His insights into psychology. When you think in pictures, you have a clear view of what you want. And it's those pictures that drive you. When he told me about the story of how he shot Ojuju, you know, the challenges he faced and had to persevere through every one of them because of the picture he saw that he was a slave to, I knew I was in the right place. I knew I was in the right place.
I love the thrill. I love the piecing together of a project and seeing it come to life. I love the fact that it is a dynamic story. It is not, I get bored of dramas. I like that it's a real story, real in the sense that it touches real people, it touches on real aspects of everyday living of a majority of young people in Nigeria today. I like the challenge that came with putting it together in spite of all the things we didn't have. I'm basically focusing on what we did have going for us and making it work at the end of the
day. I had a point where we had to break a car glass. And having to break somebody's glass was so crazy. Now, I had to like go think on how, we don't have the resource on a breakaway glass. And I was able to like just improvise and then get it away and then go to the surface. But the most challenging part was the rain scene. Yeah. It was a rain scene, because at the point, when we shot Old Town, was a dry season, and then we needed to make a rain, and I had times where I had to like go on boxers to make it rain. So struggling to like pull the hose, make the pipe, and then make it rain. It was very, very stressful, but it was very interesting. And thank God it came out clean and smart.
And CJ is quite visual. He's quite a visual director, which is not the case for some directors. He knows what look he wants. He even knows what lighting he wants, which is quite unusual, and he knows what kind of camera angles he wants. He knows what kind of style. It's easier. It's a lot easier. I understand him more. I understand what he wants more. It's not 100%, obviously. Sometimes I know exactly what he's thinking, and he'll say this shot, and I say, "Oh, you mean that shot from that film?" Because I know now what kind of, or beginning to understand his style. Also, what I really like is that because he's so much against the conventional, you know, when you're doing shooting a film, master shot, two shot, single, so on, blah 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 blah. But he's not really into that. So he's pushing the boundaries, and also challenging me as a DOP to come, you know, to be able to achieve the kind of shots he's looking for.
The truth is, this is the second time I am working with this director, this producer, and this cinematographer. I was pretty excited when they told me about the project because I had seen firsthand what they were able to accomplish with the first project we were involved in.
It's been great working with some really great hands in the industry. I mean, I came to the set and I saw like some really good hands among the crew members, even the cast and all. It's been cool. Like the makeup artists, Auntie Susan, Peju, Kunle in their own departments, the sound person, Mohammed and Murphy, King Solomon, our producer, Oge Ugu, and my director. CJ Obasi. This is the first time I'm working with CJ. CJ is one director who just, I don't know, I've worked with a couple of directors and some are equally really good. But then CJ is exceptionally good. He's good at his craft. This is someone who, it's just like CJ is filmmaking is CJ. You can't take that away from him. He has so much passion for the thing that you wonder, if we have like so many people like this who have passion for film, then the industry will go really far. And I have so much faith in him. Then Mr. Tunji, the cinematographer, who when he speaks, you don't hear one thing he says because he has a British accent. And then at the point, I can't hear what you're saying. And he's like, oh, okay, sorry, let me slow down. He's really good at what he does. Everybody is just good with what they do, all the PAs and everybody. I can't mention everybody's names at the moment, but then it's really a cool cast and crew. I mean, it's really a great experience. And then my co-actors,
they know themselves. It was really cool working with each and every one of them.
I love my director, CJ. I love CJ so much. He's an amazing director, a perfectionist. He always gets it right. Everyone on this set, I'm talking about the cast and the crew, they're awesome people. And it's so much fun. I like everything about this place. I like the breeze. I like the fact that it's close to nature. It's just really beautiful. It's been really interesting, you know, shooting on this set and connecting with everybody here, both my colleagues on set, the actors and the crew as well. It's been an awesome experience. I want to come back here and do more stuff.
The director himself, like I said already, he's an amazing, 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 wonderful director. And to be very candid with you guys, this guy's got my loyalty for as long as I decide to act. I love his stories, I love the direction, I love his directorial style. I love everything about him. He's one who brings out the best in you. He doesn't really tell you, this is what I expect from you. You sit down, you have a heart-to-heart talk, he tries to break down your character for you, and it leads you to do what you know how to do best. What more can an actor ask for? I also talk about my producer, very warm-hearted, delectable woman. With Oge, it's family. You can never, ever, ever stop wanting to be around Oge. She makes things happen in her quiet, subtle way. Every day on this set is a ball. It's a learning curve, but it's a ball. Working with great minds, working with people who are passionate about what they want to do, about what they want to accomplish, trying to bring out a story into real life and bring you viewers into the life of people. I mean, it's awesome. I love this production. I love the people in it. Talking about the sound guys, Murphy and MM, awesome guys, awesome guys. Talking about the light guy, Muri, I love that guy. Talking about my fellow cast, my fellow actors, Paul, Tommy, Ifunada, Lucy, Ame, every other person also part of this project. I mean, I think we kind of like train out a challenge to ourselves. And because we're so much into the story, because we so much believe in what we're doing, and we so much have a common vision, we're bringing out our best. The energy is so freaking high. You can feel it. You can feel it in Old Town. You can feel it in camp. You can feel it. You can feel it from the costume to the sound, to the director, to even the extras, to even the people of Old Town. The energy is positively vibrating. It's a fiery wind blowing out here right now.
It's been an amazing cast. Brutus Mfom, Ifeanyi Delvin, Ifuenada, and some people whose names I can't seem to remember right now. Please forgive me. You've all been really, 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 really immense. Every day with you guys has been a learning day. It's been wonderful. I learned from all of you. You guys give me so, so much. And sometimes I'm afraid I don't give you nearly as much or as enough as you have given me. And it's it warms my heart.
I have an awesome crew. I have an awesome crew, of course. You know, I have number one on the list is my DOP, Tunji Akinsanyiwa, who's, you know, I like to make jokes and say Gonzalez Inaritu has Lubezki, and I have Akinsanyiwa. That's kind of like the working team we have going. You know, I see myself making a lot of films with him because he understands how I think. He understands my cinematography. He understands, you know, how I like to light and how I like to make films and how I like to, you know, basically shoot stuff. He understands basically my train of thought, and he's an amazing person. I learn from him every day. You know, he's like a professor, you know. So so yeah, it's fun working with him every time. It's always a challenge. We challenge each other, and you know, I learn so much from him, and it's a brilliant collaboration. And of course, you know, my lovely wife, my producer, she's probably going to beat me because I didn't mention her first. You know, but you know, she's a great producer. We wouldn't be able to make this film because of without her. You know, she puts everything together. You know, performs miracles. Basically, we have a great production designer, Ebuka Mike. Though he's all over the place, but you know, you know, he gets stuff done, you know, and he does those amazing stuff that, you know, you never thought would be possible, but he just makes it happen. And we have, you know, so many people on this set that, you know, from the PM to the, from the camera team to, you know, the gaffer, Muitala, to the production assistants, you know, basically everyone here is on top of their game, you know, and you can't have anything less, really, especially when you have so many things against you in terms of resources and in terms of, you know, not having everything you need, you know, but you need people who love film, people who are dedicated, and people who just, who have like higher ideals as to what they want to achieve in film, you know, who place the idea of film above anything else, you know, and because of that, you know, I've been able to, you know, keep doing what I'm doing. I would never be able to, you know, make films the way I make films if I didn't have this team of people, you know, working, if I wasn't working with the team of people that I have, you know, on this project.
I want people, you know, who see this in the cinema or wherever, to know that we have amazing filmmakers with great stories and great actors, you know, and actresses who can really tell the stories that are out of the box and just make you fall in love with everything. I want people to know that, you know, because of who we are and what we have done with Old Town, I want people to know that Nigerians are very creative people and we just do awesome in whatever field that we are in. I want people to see Nigeria differently and just, you know, believe more in us, invest in the film industry, give us the billions and the, you know, billions and dollars to make more blockbuster, top-notch films, feature films, and just really just grow.
It can be frustrating, you know, working with limited budget, working with limited resources in film, especially making a film. Making a film is hard enough as it is, but when it's even harder when, you know, you have to manage, you have to find ways to compromise and, you know, stuff like that, you know. But, you know, the thing I always say is, you know, film is, you know, is, you know, it's my life, you know, it's the only thing I want to do with my life. So if I'm not making film, you know, I'll probably kill myself or something. Well, I'm kidding, but, you know, you get my point. So the thing is, I'm going to make films either way, you know, if, whether there's funding or no funding. So I would rather work with the resources I have, with the team that I have, to create as close to creating what we would like to see out there, you know, rather than, you know, sit down and whine and complain about not getting funding, about people not giving you money to do anything. You know, I just, you know, I've been raised, you know, from when I was a child, I've been raised by my parents to just do stuff. You know, if you want to do something, just do it. Don't complain, don't whine, just do it. You know, so that has always been my approach, especially for film. You know, I believe we can only get better, you know, and it's a learning curve. It's a growing trajectory. You know, there's no sloping down here. Just keep rising higher and higher. And as films get better, and, you know, as, you know, we grow together as a team and as a collaboration, you know, we can only present better stuff. Well, I've been lucky to make film, to make Ojuju, and now I'm making Old Town. And I think the reason why films like Ojuju and now Old Town will stand out from all the other films that will be coming out in the market or that are coming out from this market is the simple fact that it doesn't look anything like anything coming out from these parts. I mean, you have Nigerian actors, yes, and they're speaking local dialects, yes. But in terms of style, in terms of tone, in terms of storytelling, in terms of cinematography, in terms of, you know, lighting, everything, every single aspect of the filmmaking process has been, a special care has been taken to ensure that it doesn't follow the norm. Like I told you, I've been working on this script since 2011. So we had like a long time to really incubate on this particular film. We had a storyboard, we had a short list. We have guys who have been just basically thinking about it and thinking about how we can make this work, you know, and to finally get to the point where we're about to make this film, we had to assemble the best hands in the game, you know, to make it happen. So yes, you know, we have budget limitations, but we don't have manpower limitations. We don't have thinking limitations, you know. The only limitations we place on ourselves is the limitation that budget places on us, which can be, yes, it's frustrating. But once you can, you know, push and push and push and push through, you find that there's more that you can offer, you know, even with limited resources.
It is going to be very, very, very entertaining. The pictures are going to be awesome because technically this is probably one of the best films to come out of Nigeria and probably Africa. The cinematographer, Mr. Tunji Akinsehinwa, has been awesome to work with. He exudes a sense of confidence, sure-footedness. When he gives you instructions, he's very clear, very concise. You know exactly what is expected of you. The same with the director. He's imaginative. He's constantly trying to push the envelope. It's, I think, a refreshing feeling to see someone so young try to do something so different. Someone so young who knows the rules, obviously, and decides to bend them or sometimes rewrite them in the course of making film. It's been fun.
Watch it, embrace it, get used to it, because we're not going to stop now. My favorite saying is there's always something new out of Africa, and there's always something new out of Nigeria, especially. Made in Nigeria, about Nigeria, but for an international audience.
I love Old Town.
Old Town, Old Town, Old Town.
The Old Town.
It's a fury wind blowing out here right now. That's Old Town for you, baby.
Oops. To me, Ojuju was but this one will be a killer. I guess they should expect the bomb. Because Old Town is the real deal.
The audience should expect, not to sound cliche, something different. So the audience should have a very, very open mind and keep it open. The audience should not expect a textbook film. We don't play by the rules, basically. So they should not expect that, oh, things are usually told this way or done this way, and hey, why are these people not keeping to that rule? Because you're not going to see any of that. We're completely out of the box, and we went all out on that in this film.
The audience should expect something fresh. Yeah, I know every filmmaker says that whenever they make a film, like, the audience should expect something fresh. No, I mean it with all of my being. The audience should expect something fresh. From the very opening scene to the last take, it's something that you will leave the theater or the hall, wherever it is that you're watching, satisfied. Even if you don't like the film, you're going to leave satisfied.
Go see Old Town.